It's an honor to be here and participate in this symposium for Rioab. So first, I was thinking of presenting some results from the DERC survey. So I'll do it in one slide, because I think Vivian is going to present more. So the main result, that's why I'm doing one slide, because we combine three two-point correlation functions, namely galaxy-galaxy, galaxy-shear, and shear-shear. And from this combination, we derive results from two parameters that we're most sensitive to. It's the density of matter, and this parameter SA, which is related to the C2IA. And all I want to say is that we have agreement on the CDM, and there's no change to the plan. So this is it, okay? That's what we have about. So I still know the CDM rules. So this is not what I'm going to talk about, actually. So Vivian is going to present some slides about this. So what I want to talk about is something different. So I think I'm becoming old. And since I'm becoming old, and I look back and I start to remember things. And I think I'm not a historian or anything, but I want to give you my sense on how the community grew in these years. And you have had a very, very important role in the growth of the community. Okay. So this is a disclaimer. I have not yet worked with you up, but I hope it's never too late. You're not really retired, are you? Okay. So this is my very short summary of cosmology, how it started in Brazil, and I'm sure I'm going to piss people off by saying this. But this is, I think, roughly. This is the important word here, roughly. So Jaime Teomono, he got his PhD in Princeton in 1950 in particle physics with John Reeder and Eugene Beaker. And then he spent 2 years in Princeton again in 1971 because he was fleeing from the military dictatorship, which I hope does not ever happen again. And starts working in GR because Reeder changed from particle physics to GR. And he came back to PUC, and started a group doing gravitational physics of GR, gravitational generally. Somewhat independently, Mario Novello got a PhD in Geneva and came back to CPF and started a group in cosmology in 1976. And I also add that Ugo Lovani at my institute in the 70s also did some work in general relativity and cosmology. And Tiomo and Novello, they formed a generation of cosmologists. I think Ademir was the last student of Tiomo, if I'm not mistaken. But they're all theoretically inclined. Right? or like the blackboard that Paul showed. But there were not much data at the time anyway, so it was okay. Now, one thing that I think was very important is that Novello started a series of schools, Brazilian schools on cosmology and gravitation, 1978. And the series is still going on. This year was the 17th edition. And I think this was very important, so it was the 14th and the 40th anniversary of the school. I think this is very important. It was very important for me, because one of the reasons was very important. I attended this one in 1984, and one reason was very important because I met you. This was the first time I met Yoav. And Yoav was a bit older than me, and he was already doing his PhD in cosmology, with someone that was not formed by these people, not by Tiomo, but was someone independent for Novello, Shanda. So I have no idea how Shanda ended up here. But he was a particle physicist, and I think maybe you influenced him to change into more particle and cosmology. And so this school, I was finishing my master's at that time, and this school was also very important for me for another reason. That's when I met Dave Schrum. So look at this, Rocky Cole and Dave Schrum came in 1984. And so this is the reason why I could go to the US for my PhD, because of Dave Schrum that I met in this school. Now, another thing that's another series of workshops, which I think was very important, is this workshop that was started by Ruben Dofer. He's a 2002. And this workshop had the aim of bringing together, in an informal setting, Brazilian researchers from different fields. It was loosely related to physics in space, or new physics in space. And I think many of you attended this thing, right? I think you all did. So it was a collection of topics, CMBs, or physical plasmas, black holes, rotational waves, dark matter, galaxies, etc. And I think this was really a cauldron, you know, of people getting together and talking. And this was, in my opinion, was very important to build a community. A community that was more interested in observations. This was really fundamental. When again, Yoav was important, I distinctly remember this talk of Yoav at about 10 top models for dark energy. You don't remember? So I had to do
just another one. Just
another. Are you sure it's because Sunday is here? Okay, I'll tell you. This is something you can do nowadays. He put a picture of Giselle Bündchen, I remember correctly. You remember that, right? It was a picture of Giselle Bündchen. He was talking about the top 10 models. in dark energy. This is something you cannot do these days. It's just that you can't. Those days you can't. And there were some traditions that were introduced, like this paredão. You can forget the paredão, right? You remember the paredão. You have no idea what paredão is. No, you went to paredão. Paredão is when you put people, and paredão means the wall, you put people against the wall and shoot. So we did that with questions. So we put all the speakers, at the end of the day, went in front, and people were shooting questions at them. And so this was also important because one of the things I realized is that students in Brazil, they're very shy, they don't ask questions. So this was a way of making students ask questions. This was very good. So traditions like that. So the latest edition of this series of workshops was in 2016. What? And this is the picture of the workshop. This was the latest one in 2016 at IFE. Maybe we should think of doing this again.
I just want to point out that this was the new physics in space was the workshop where I met my PhD advisor.
No, actually not. I'll show you why.
Is it the same?
No.
No.
So I tell you the challenge is there. So I believe this workshop was instrumental in what became, in my opinion, in a phase transition, which was engagement of the cosmology Brazilian community, international observational collaborations. So many theorists became involved in these collaborations. And Marcelo, a theorist, really, bona fide theorist, became involved in observational collaborations. So it's amazing. So you have an important role in this process. He attended the talks, was always very active. So we can see involvement of Brazilians in all of this and many others international collaborations. It's a complex process of participating in international collaborations, as you heard, and we're still learning how to do this. Okay, I don't think we're completely in there. Now, I remember, so I was one of the students that joined the project, so I remember when I decided to become involved in dark energy survey. I don't know if you remember, but it was during was the day we were out of the PhD. You remember that? What's going on? So I went to your office, and then we started to talk, so I was in Yoav's office after the defense, and I decided to follow Yoav's example. So if Yoav can join, I can join too. So if Yoav can join, should be live, should be really nice, so should also. So I did, and the rest is history. Okay. So in 2009, a new series of workshops started. It was called Challenges of the Physics in Space. And this one was a bona fide international workshop. The other one was not international, it was just for Brazilians. Which was nice because it was a very informal atmosphere. But this one was also very important because it brought outstanding researchers to Brazil. Like, look at it. That's where you have been.
hours lecture. He asked me, no, offered asked me to give a, like a 4 hours lecture.
Four offer did that?
I mean, I remember this never ended.
It was never ending, right?
Now it's just 3.
So this was very important also because, you know, people like Vivian got in touch with the Wayne Wu and then went to Chicago to do her papers. This is really important for students and also for researchers. So the, I think the latest edition was the 6th, maybe Joab doesn't remember. But, I think he organized it. And if I'm not mistaken, I think after Ofer retired, he asked us to help organizing this series of workshops. I think I would organize new physics, he would organize challenges, something like that. At least I think you don't remember. So now, in my opinion, our community has matured. Okay, our cosmology community has matured and is now more balanced between theory and observation. That's very good. Now, but we should keep this balance, okay? And how to keep this balance? So there is a way of keeping this balance that someone mentioned in a movie. For sure, this.
Pode ser errado. Não mais.
ahead, go first. Start again. Start again.
Thank you. Thank you.